Welcome to Postscripts here on Fox 2. It's our weekly look at news and politics with our news partners at the St. Louis Post-Dispatch. Joining me in studio is the national and political editor, Christopher Ave. And in D.C. today, what a week he's had, it's the Post political reporter, Chuck Rausch. Good to see you, Chuck. We'll talk to you in just a second.
Hi.
All right, not a week goes by that something big doesn't happen in D.C. But this week, the big story was something that didn't happen. Here is Fox News Chief White House Correspondent John Roberts with the latest from late this week.
In the state dining room today, President Trump gathered together all the Republican senators who would come for a spirited sales pitch on getting rid of Obamacare.
Any senator who votes against starting debate is really telling America that you're fine with Obamacare. But being fine with Obamacare isn't an option for another reason, because it's gone. It's failed.
While the vote next week is to simply repeal Obamacare and replace it later, President Trump today repeated his call to repeal and replace Obamacare at the same time, and that Congress should stay in Washington until it's done.
My message today is really simple. We have to stay here. We shouldn't leave town, and we should hammer this out and get it done.
The president also chastised senators who repeatedly voted to repeal Obamacare during the Obama administration, when they knew their vote was nothing more than a political show.
For 7 years, you had an easy route. We'll repeal, we'll replace, and he's never going to sign it. But I'm signing it. So it's a little bit different.
The three senators who voted to repeal Obamacare in 2015 but say they're against it now will come in for some special White House attention, as did Senator Dean Heller of Nevada, an opponent of repeal and replace, who found himself seated right next to the president.
You didn't go out there. This was the one we were worried about. You weren't there, but you're going to be. You're going to be there. Look, he wants to remain a senator, doesn't he?
As he seeks to woo senators on Obamacare repeal, President Trump is lashing out at reports he had a secret second meeting with Russian President Vladimir Putin at the G20 2 weeks ago. The president tweeting, quote, fake news story of secret dinner with Putin is, quote, sick. All G20 leaders and spouses were invited by the Chancellor of Germany. Press knew. The president talked with Putin for more than 2 hours in a bilateral meeting in Hamburg on July 7th. That night, at the official G20 dinner, the president spent more time with Putin, one-on-one with only a Russian interpreter. The White House denied a report the two spoke for nearly an hour and would not disclose the content of the conversation.
This was a social dinner where the president spoke with many world leaders, as is the purpose. I think it would be incredibly awkward for them to all sit at a dinner and not speak to each other.
The White House accused the press of having a double standard, pointing out that President Obama had private conversations at previous G20s that the press never made an issue of.
There's a very different standard that you guys like to draw between this White House and previous administrations, and you try to create a situation that frankly just wasn't there.
On Obamacare, the Congressional Budget Office today released its estimate of the 10-year effect of the repeal-only bill. It found that an additional 32 million people would be without health insurance, while the deficit was reduced by some $473 billion. And some breaking news to report, Fox News has learned that the first son-in-law, Jared Kushner, will give a behind-closed-doors interview to the Senate Intelligence Committee on Monday. Donald Trump Jr. and Paul Manafort, the president's former campaign manager, have been invited to appear next Wednesday before the Senate Judiciary Committee. At the White House, John Roberts, Fox News.
All right, Chuck, there is a lot to unpack with this, with that story and this whole week up there in D.C. with you guys. Let's start with the health care thing. Donald Trump at one point said, the president said, let's just let the whole thing implode. But now we find out that would leave a bigger mess than actually passing something. So where do the Republican lawmakers go from here?
Well, I think they're going to what Senator Blunt calls regular order. And I think that's kind of where he and some other senators have wanted to go from the beginning, and that is to open up the bill, open it up to any sort of amendments, and potentially even have hearings down the road if that fails on some sort of new vehicle. In some ways, Senator Blunt has kind of been forecasting that it would go that direction anyway. And if that happens, then I think you're going to see maybe more Democrats stepping forward to try to amend the bill or participate in the process. So it's sort of inevitably going to that, I think, eventually. But we've got to go through some more machination and choreography first.
You know, Christopher, from this standpoint, Trump was right on this. He said, you Republicans have had 7 years of campaigning on this. That was easy. Now you actually have to do something. He really called him out in this case.
Yeah, It is interesting that he called out members of his own party, but Trump is frustrated that they were not able to pass a bill that it can attract enough elements of the Republican Party, left, middle, and right. So far, they've been unable to do that. And what I find interesting, John, is if what Chuck said actually happens, if they open up the bill to a bipartisan conversation, if they allow Democrats to put in their ideas, if they vote up or down on amendments, you know, that would be sort of the first time health care in many years since before Obamacare was passed would be bipartisan. Remember, Obamacare was passed only by Democrats. Remember Pelosi saying, you know, you have to pass the bill to know what's in it, that sort of thing. You know, it was very controversial at the time, remains controversial, particularly among Republicans. Now, if the Republicans do open this process up to Democrats, there is a chance, oddly enough, as strange as it may sound, that a bipartisan piece of legislation might actually get to the finish line.
What? Bipartisan? Exactly. The two sides talking? Hey, Chuck, I know a lot of people watching this show are probably fans of House of Cards. There was a guy sitting next to President Trump at the Republican luncheon where Trump started turning the screws on these guys. Now, most people didn't recognize him. Why was he sitting right next to the president?
Well, one of the sort of unspoken rules of Washington is seating charts are important. And the seating chart in this circumstance had Senator Dean Heller of Nevada sitting next to him, who has been a holdout on this. It represents a state that's been trending Democratic, I think is worried. His Republican governor there is worried about what would happen with Medicaid and the commitment that they've made to covering people of lower income under health care. And so Heller was sitting at his right hand, literally at the right hand of the president, and he basically called him out in front of the other senators and frankly the world. And this isn't the first time he's done this. In previous conversations that he's had with Republican senators up there, he's had potential holdouts or those that are not necessarily totally on board with him, Senator Murkowski among others, sitting right at his side. So I think it was a pointed and poignant moment there that Trump tried to make. Remember, Trump's PAC, one of the PACs that's affiliated with him, has already run negative ads on this Republican senator in Nevada who's up for re-election next year.
Dean, you do want to be senator again, right? It reminds me of House of Cards. Okay, I find it interesting, too, here now that Paul Ryan is like, okay, fine, forget health care, time to talk tax reform. But a lot of people are saying, if you guys can't get health care done, how are you going to do taxes? I think taxes will be easier, personally.
I don't know about that.
You don't think so, huh?
I don't know. No, because you're talking about, who do you target? Is it going to be quote unquote tax cuts for the rich? Is it going to be trickle down? You know, who's the winner? Who's the loser in it? The Democrats have already started making noise about it, saying don't go down this road. We need to be involved. Senator McCaskill made that point earlier that one thing you should learn, if anything, that A, it's not as easy as it looks, and B, you should do it bipartisan from the beginning. And interestingly enough, in that same conversation, Senator McCaskill admitted it was a mistake for Democrats to do what they did in 2010 and pass essentially a Democratic bill. In fact, it was a totally Democratic bill. Can I make one other point?
Yep,
there
very
was
quickly.
Something said about two weeks ago, a senator from Pennsylvania made a pretty interesting comment that kind of got overlooked but was really to the heart of what's going on here. Senator Pat Toomey, a Republican from Pennsylvania, said, "We didn't expect Trump to win. That's why we didn't have a plan together." And I think that's part of what Trump was calling him out on. You didn't believe enough in me to have a plan together when we came to this moment, and now here we are.
Frank Underwood. I mean, that's all my life. This is it. We're living in reality TV. Chuck, always great to see you. Have yourself a great Sunday, and we will talk to you soon.
It's great. Great. See ya.
All right, still to come, a school district where nearly every student qualifies for free reduced lunches does something extraordinary. In case you missed the big news from Jennings this week, we're about to find out how they're taking steps that I believe could change that community forever. Straight ahead on Postscripts.